Do you love Airtable, but you find yourself wondering, what does the future have in store for this awesome software? Well, if that's the case, then look no further, because in this video, I am recording my predictions, 6 key predictions for 2026 and beyond. So if you're looking to get some predictions for the future, then look no further. You're in the right place. Let's hop on into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools, and Airtable is at the core of pretty much all of the stuff that we are building. So it's very important for us, at least, to be thinking forward about what's coming up for Airtable. And if you're using Airtable in your organization, then this will matter to you as well. Now, before we get into the heart of the video, I first want to invite you to join me for some templates. I've put together 5 key templates that we offer for free to anyone who signs up at gapconsulting.io/templates. These templates will each be accompanied by their own video, 5 core use cases for business, and you can immediately copy, duplicate these templates, and take ownership of them, including the interfaces that we've built. So go ahead and sign up for those templates if you're looking for a way to get started in Airtable quickly, or if you're looking for a little inspiration for your next build. But without further ado, let's hop on into the heart of the video. I've got 6 key takeaways, or hot takes, if you will, on what I think is going to be happening for Airtable in the near future and beyond. Now, I also want to preface this by saying I do not have any insider knowledge. These are really just things that I kind of just think are going to happen. It's just my own thoughts, my own predictions. So take it for what it's worth, and let's not blow this out of proportion. I'm doing my best to predict the future here, and this is really just for fun, right? Let's talk about those things that I would love to see Airtable do, and I'm hopeful they will do, because I think it's going to give them a strong competitive advantage as they expand further in the no-code space. So let's jump on into number 1. Obviously, it would be crazy for me to record any kind of predictions without including anything about AI. And so my number 1 key takeaway here is that I think AI is going to become even more central in the workflow process inside of Airtable. And that means a lot of things, a lot of new ways that we can integrate AI into Airtable, and I'm predicting that Airtable will find ways to allow us to engage with AI even more. So some ways that it currently is not being used, I'm thinking about in the workflow process with automations. How cool would it be if I didn't have to know how to go about building an automation and I could just type into a prompt and describe to AI what I'm trying to do? And then AI could build that automation for me. Is this possible? Well, I think so, right? We're already starting to see similar type of things coming from some other tools in the no-code space like Zapier. Zapier is really leaning into AI a lot, and I'm sure that Airtable is watching that and considering how they can incorporate AI into their own automation workflow. So this is a hot takeaway for me. I think that AI is going to be integrated much more deeply in Airtable, specifically in the workflow component, namely automations, but also more so in formulas, maybe in the way that we're building different tables and fields. There's a lot of AI already being used in Airtable, but I really think we're going to lean into the workflow component and see even more AI on that particular section in 2026 and beyond. Number 2 for Airtable is I think we are going to see a lot more invested into interfaces. Airtable has been really aggressively expanding their interfaces feature over the last couple years, and I don't think that's about to slow down anytime soon. So my second big prediction here is that interfaces are going to become even more important to Airtable builders. We're going to see a lot more expansion in that space. And really, this is going to mean for those teams that are using Airtable, but they have not already leaned into interfaces, I think that they are going to start to feel even more of a pull to start integrating interfaces into their solutions. And this is kind of wild to me because I talk to a lot of clients or prospective clients, folks from small, medium businesses all the way up to large enterprise. And this is like kind of my own experience just in speaking with those people, that they're not really leveraging interfaces today. Within Airtable, there's many, many different clients who are still sharing access to the back-end components, the data, and they're not sharing access to the interface layer because they haven't had time to really lean into interfaces as an Airtable user. So I'm predicting that those people are going to really feel a lot of pressure in 2026 to embrace interfaces even more, because I think Airtable is going to be making rapid expansion, rapid improvement in their interface components. So as they're launching this out, the core reason I'm predicting is because Airtable has identified that interfaces are a core piece of why people are using the tool. It's so easy for you to build a solution and then share limited access, limited visibility with specific players on the team. So you can have different interfaces, different experiences for everyone. And so in this way, I think Airtable is really acknowledging that this is one of their key features that is attracting enterprise clients to the business, and they are going to want to lean into this even more. In terms of what they might do for interfaces, I think maybe that we're going to see more views being incorporated into interfaces. Over the years, we've seen slow incorporation of the different view types being added. And so I think we're going to see more of this. Also, some more advancement on maybe buttons or the way that we can actually mold an interface, like maybe improvements to the UX, things like that, so that we can customize even further. And then I also think that there will be a greater focus on mobile-friendly interfaces as well, right? So a lot of clients are starting to use Airtable interfaces more and more in the field, on mobile devices, on tablets, and I think we're going to see greater expansion in this area for 2026 and beyond. My number three prediction is almost more of like a wish list, if I'm being honest. This is something I would love Airtable to do. Do I think they're going to actually do it? Oh man, I really hope that they do, but I can't really say with any certainty that I really think it's going to happen in the next year or so, but I would love Airtable to focus on building a marketplace for creators to sell their stuff. And if we're looking for some kind of a benchmark here, I think we can look to Notion. Notion has created some variation of a marketplace, and I know that Airtable and Notion are very much in lockstep, competing in a similar space. So it would not surprise me all that much if Airtable is aware of this marketplace and is wondering how they might be able to implement something similar themselves for their own builders. And why would I personally love this? Well, two reasons. Number one, templates make it so much easier for new users to adopt the software. When you first sit down and look at Airtable, and it has like infinite layers of complexity, you might get kind of put off by that. You think, gosh, all right, the tool looks really nice, but what am I supposed to do with this? Like, there's so much potential here, and I don't know where to start. So templates are one of those ways that we can really lean in and help people who are new users to the tool to really understand, like, how does this work within your particular workflow? What does it look like for your organization to get into Airtable? What would that be like for you? A template kind of is that first point, right? It's usually not the case that a template will solve all of your problems, but if it helps you visualize what is possible and allows you to start building and, you know, start going down the rabbit hole of adopting Airtable in your organization, that's a win-win for everybody. Because on one hand, users are making their businesses and their processes much more efficient. And on the other hand, Airtable is acquiring new customers. It's a symbiotic relationship. Everyone wins. Now, the other big reason I would love to see more templates and particularly a marketplace is because creators such as myself would have a potential monetization strategy for going forward and saying, hey, here's some really cool stuff that we built. We own the IP here. We would like to get some profit or some revenue as a product of having sold this or sharing this. So allow us to do that in a way that, you know, brings money back into our organization. And this is just going to further expand and enhance the whole ecosystem for Airtable. More creators building more stuff, therefore more people adopting more templates and new users being brought onto the platform. So I really think it's a win-win-win all around. And I'm hopeful that Airtable is considering building something like this in the near future. My number four hot take here is a prediction around AI again, of course. Like two of the six, but gotta be about AI. It's 2025. We can't talk about anything else. AI, how else do I see it coming into Airtable? Really in the form of a co-pilot or an assistant. So Airtable already has a very cool, what they've called co-builder. And right now, if you were to go to Airtable and drop into building a new solution from scratch, it would ask you if you want to work with the co-builder, assuming that you have AI turned on for your workspace. And so in this way, you can actually communicate with a bot and, you know, go back and forth in a chat prompt telling it what you want to have built. It will build the back end and it will build the interfaces. No automations yet, but still, that's two big takeaways right there, right? I mean, that does a lot of the heavy lifting for us. Now, this is wonderful. This is an awesome feature, and I don't mean to talk badly about it, but it's really like V1, version one of incorporating AI into Airtable. So what I'm imagining really is a co-pilot, an assistant that I can pop up as I'm working in Airtable and say, hey, can you build me another table and link it over here and give me these four fields? So rather than only being able to access that AI co-builder at the beginning of a new database, instead being able to bring it up and like interact with it within an existing database as well. As I'm building, I can remove fields. Maybe it warns me, hey, those fields are actually linked to something or could cause an automation to fail. Or on the other hand, I say, hey, this is the new thing I'm trying to build. Like, how do I build that? Can you help me add that to this particular database, et cetera? So lots of cool stuff, lots of amazing potential here. And I'm really looking forward to the greater incorporation of AI. And as a quick side note, a lot of people ask me, you know, are you worried about the whole consulting business going away? Are you going to lose the ability to serve clients and all of this if AI expands in this way? And frankly, the answer remains no. If anything, what this does is it allows us to provide services for less money than before, which just means that we can help more people at a more reasonable rate. And at the end of the day, again, everybody wins. I don't think it's actually going to take jobs away or anything like that. It's going to make everyone that much more efficient, and we're going to be building faster, quicker, stronger. Everybody wins. All right, my fifth hot take here is some stuff that I feel like maybe Airtable hasn't enhanced a lot in the last three, four, five years or so, and how might they go about doing that? So there are a couple of features, two key features in specific, that I think could use a little bit of love on the Airtable side of things. So we all know that Airtable already has forms, and Airtable has the page designer, allows you to create PDFs or some sort of page based on your data in Airtable. And of course, forms, fairly straightforward. People can submit data and it automatically adds data to Airtable. Well, where do these two features currently fall short? Let's first break down forms. Forms do not allow for data to be entered into multiple tables. I think this is probably one of the biggest things that forms do not do. Give you a quick example here. Maybe I am entering a new contact into my CRM and I have their business, the company organization, already in my CRM. Well, I don't need to create a new company. All I need to do is create a new client and add them to the company organization, right? No problem. Linked relationship, two records. I'm only creating one and I'm linking it to another record. But if I don't already have the company in my CRM, I need to create two records. Airtable Forms cannot handle this in one form right now. So if you were to build this with an Airtable form setup, you'd have to create two different Airtable forms. And the first form would say, add the company here. Oh, you don't have the company? Go ahead and create it with this form. Then you'd create the company. And then you go back to the first form, create the contact, and link it to the newly minted company. So that's a lot of steps. Like, why do we need to move around that much? It's way easier to have one form. In that form, we simply say, this is the new company, and it creates the company all in one. So my hope is that Airtable is looking at their forms and saying, this is a really cool feature that we could include that would really embrace and expand our form capabilities. And I don't think that forms have had a ton of love over the last few years. It would be great to see this incorporated there. Now, the other low-hanging fruit for Airtable here is in relation to that page designer. Page designer is in an app which used to be called blocks, which are in the data layer of Airtable. So So you have to have the builder access to the back end. I'm not talking about people with interface access, but people who have access to the back end would be able to open this up and see the page that was designed on a PDF based on the template. And they could print that out or save it as a PDF or whatever. Not very automated, and there wasn't a ton of flexibility with this tool. What I would love to see is either expansion on this feature or some kind of acquisition from Airtable to really focus on creating PDFs from data that lives in Airtable. Because this is something that we see on so many projects that we work with our clients. I really think it's a low-hanging opportunity, low-hanging fruit for Airtable to pick up on this and really lean in and build some native integration right inside the platform so that we can create PDFs naturally, natively, inside of Airtable and with automation. Now, my last takeaway here or prediction for 2026 and beyond is that Airtable continues to double down on enterprise. We've already started to see this over the last few years with Airtable really starting to focus on the enterprise client. And I think we're going to see even more of that as we continue on. And this is kind of the natural life cycle of many software tools. They start off kind of mid-market or being, more horizontal, right? Just being approachable by many different industries across many different segments and different sizes. And ultimately, as software continues to mature, I think it's very natural for them to lean into the enterprise clients and start to see more and more on that scale. Now, I don't think that that means that it's going to fall apart for the small, medium business. Still think Airtable is a fantastic solution. And frankly, we run our entire business on Airtable, and we are very much a small business. So I don't think that Airtable is necessarily going to alienate those small business clients. We've seen just more of their focus being put on those enterprise customers, and I think that we're going to see even more of that in years to come. Ultimately, this is probably a good thing for everybody because at the end of the day, the more money that's coming into Airtable, the greater expansion they see, the more it lifts all the ships. Rising tides lifts all ships. And so in this case, even the small businesses are going to see enhanced features and improvements to Airtable in general that will help all of us work more efficiently. I'm very curious to know what you think about my predictions for 2026 and beyond. Again, I have no insider knowledge here. These are just things I would like to see, things I'm hopeful for, and things that I think would make Airtable better. What are your thoughts? What did I miss? Let me know in the comments below. If you need help, something we didn't address in the video, swing by our website. But most importantly, keep on building.